Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Andy Fagrass, the MD of MRC UK Limited, and I'll be running this session today. I'll start by presenting a short background on the growth of mobile devices and the growing need for mobile solutions. We'll then see how an agile development environment, in our case, MPower, using that you can create and deploy multi-device solutions in incredibly fast timescales. And finally, there'll be a bit of time for questions. As we go along, do ask any questions as they occur to you. I'll deal with them at the end of the session. We are using WebEx today, so to ask a question, you can use the chat icon, which should be at the top right of your screen. Okay, so right, let's go. Get going. Staff in all departments now use a wide variety of mobile devices and often want to use them to access business systems back at their office. The challenge is how we provide solutions to open up those existing systems and give secure, flexible access to remote staff on whatever devices they have to use. And users are requesting or demanding those solutions more and more in shorter and shorter timescales. So mobility is disrupting and reshaping our businesses. We need to unlock more value from our core systems, and to stay in business, we've got to deliver more and more of these mobile solutions. So let's have a look at what's going on. Right, this slide shows the usage of growth in usage of PCs, smartphones, tablets, and if I just mark one area of it, there you go. That's on smartphones, which is that it took 4 years for smartphones to reach a 6% penetration in the marketplace. If I move on to tablets to the right, that took only 2 years to reach the same penetration in the marketplace. So that's showing how the adoption of new technology is just getting faster and faster. There are newer devices coming out all the time, and users are adopting them very readily, very quickly. but businesses, well, we are adopting them. 59% of employees use mobile devices to run their business applications or subcomponents thereof. But more interestingly, I find that 81% of employees or employed adults will use personal devices at some time to access their business systems. And this is where it's out of control of the IT function as to what device, what type of device those users are using. If you think of mobile phones, there's seven different models, and in fact, the average lifespan of a mobile phone is 21 months. So every 2 years, on average, a user will have a new device. And who knows what operating system they will be running at that point. And the challenge for the IT department is, it's kind of two speeds here, but there's the looking after the legacy systems and all the good solid aspects those have of the integrity of the data about the business. There's also the need for developing these new solutions that the businesses want, and they want them very quickly. So the IT department have got to be looking professionally after the old systems at the same time in a professional fashion, but in a very nimble, fast fashion, delivering new solutions for the business. So does that mean you've got to have two IT departments, two areas of staff, or can one team provide those two levels or types of service to the business? What we'll be going through today is how with an agile development tool, the staff that look after the legacy system can also be doing nimble, innovative work that meet these new requirements of the business in those very short timescales. Okay, well, what phones should we be creating our solutions for? Well, this slide shows that the trends are all over the place. Some devices suddenly become fashionable, widely adopted, or others lose the popularity in the marketplace. And that's just a bit of history of the last few years. Who knows what's going to happen in the next few years? So looking at that, you might think Android, that's the winner for the future, but it's not the sole device out there. It has been adopted quickly. There's still plenty of BlackBerries and plenty of course, have been and always seems, it seems there always will be plenty of iPhones and other devices around. So you can't really opt for a single one. If you were to create devices, solutions for a single device, creating a native application for, say, iPhone and a native application for BlackBerry, and doing all of that for your business, if you develop for all platforms, that would cost you a lot of money, take a fair amount of time, but the risk for the business of failing to work on the devices that the user needs is minimal because you'll have addressed it. You'll have worked for every device, but it's been at a great cost. And the cost is in the physical money to do it, but also the time it's taking to create all of those. Okay, you might cut your options and home in on one device, one platform. So that saves cost, saves time. But the risk is, did you choose the right platform? And have you got the right platform that your current users actually want? So in terms of an extranet, you won't know what on earth the users are going to be using. And so you'll cut yourself off from some of your customers. So there's a great risk in that approach. So instead of that, that's why we're suggesting today mobile web applications are a better route. And mobile web applications are basically smart HTML pages that arrive in the device. So there's nothing physically stored, no programs installed on the device, but very clever modern web pages. So typically HTML5, CSS3 with AJAX technology and other things that link to the device included. And so to create mobile web applications, the cost is minimal, time is short, and the risk is minimal because you've met the requirements of all the devices. And there's a big plus on the risk here, actually, that looking forward to 2, 3, 4 years, that risk stays minimal because what you write today will work in those devices that come out 3, 4, 5 years' time. Whereas if you've written a native application, there's a risk that might not be the case. So mobile web applications cover you for all devices now and for scenarios that are going to crop up in 3, 4, 5 years' time. So it's a really good option. And other aspects of these mobile web applications, well, easier, cheaper to build, easier to deploy. If you've got many users dotted around the world, your business might have many sites, you've got customers coming in, you do not have to install anything on those devices. When they run, these web pages will arrive at the device when the user is running it. So there's no issue of are they running the right version of an application. That maintenance becomes easy because it's just maintaining the versions on the central server, and whenever a user runs, they'll pick up the latest version. So it's an easy task to look after maintenance. They can offer native capabilities and should do so. So it's a good responsive experience for the user in whatever device they're using. So if it's in a tablet, they'll expect one set of behaviors, or if they're in a smartphone, they'll expect another set of behaviors. Or if they're in a laptop PC, perhaps, or some sort of hybrid, it might be yet another set of behavior in the device. Future-proofing, yep, we've covered that. Whatever smartphones come out in 3, 5 years' time, or tablets and so on, whatever you create now should run on whatever browsers are available now. And by doing it this way, rather than via a store where is the means of delivering applications to one's device, you aren't controlled by whoever owns that store. And that avoids the costs they might impose on you, whether they list or don't list your applications. You're avoiding that risk of them being in control of you and jeopardizing your business. You are deploying the applications yourself. Okay, so we've catered so far with delivering to all the devices, be it smartphones, tablets, and so on, but what's going on in the business whilst all this is going on? So technology is changing quickly, but what about the business? Businesses are also changing very quickly. And so we need an agile development process. By agile, it means we can do this design, develop, test, release in very short timescales. The business wants a new solution. They want it quickly. You deploy it. Then they want some enhancements, some changes, some other solutions. You have to move on and do those equally quickly. You can't have very long project timescales. So an agile tool is also part of this whole approach. And what might we provide as components of our mobile web applications? Well, it's got to be real time. These are musts here. It must be real time to the core data on the central system. So if I'm at some remote city, I've got my smartphone on me, I want to be able to view data at that second of the status of orders back on our core system, back at the head office, and maybe enter and change some details about it. So that's the next bullet here. We need to be entering orders, be able to update data. It's got to be a real-time interaction with the core system. I've got to be able to do, when I'm out and about, the same sort of tasks that I might do when I'm sat at my desk in the office, but just using my phone or tablet. Usual KPI sort of views. We want to be able to see metrics of different sorts about our business on any device, PCs, tablets, smartphones. Something in mobile here, we also need to be able to receive communications by email or SMS messages because that's part of the whole experience of being on a mobile device. So we've got to be able to receive those and interact with them, linking back to core systems. I've got here a bullet saying B2B websites, also B2C. We've got to be able to cater for people that aren't just working for our company, so outside parties with security coming in and accessing our system. And so maybe even going as far as we might be providing a cloud service for our customers using this technology. And final bullets here, part of that native experience on the device could include signature capture, mapping, and other things. And the interface experience has got to be tailored for each user for how they want to work when they're out and about. So that tailoring could mean that they, when they're in the office, they're doing a more thorough task, if you like. But when they're out and about, they're not interested in the peripheral aspects of some screens. They just want the core data entry functionality because they want to get on with their task very quickly on the mobile device. So it might be some tailoring so it works a slightly different way for a mobile user versus a user who sat in the office. Okay, let's get on and look at some software. So what I'm going to do here is just change the size of the browser. We're going to log on to the Empower interface. Great, okay, now we're logged on. So this is our agile development tool. So this is Empower. I'm now going to create an application. So click that button. Different types of apps here. We're going to go through creating an interactive inquiry. We're going to be able to view customer information and drill down. We'll run it on a PC, tablet, and smartphone. So hit to create a new application. I'm going to create a retrieval. And I'm going to call it here a customer and inquiry. If I can type, let's do that again. It's an inquiry. Okay, so giving it a name. Next thing down on the left here is we'll choose a type of a template, a type of program. So if I choose calendar, you'll see that to the right is an image of that looking like a calendar. If I choose multiple record inquiry, is an image showing a multiple record or listing inquiry, and I'll stay with that. I'll choose a multiple record one. Click save and proceed. And now see a list of tables to choose from. I'll choose a customer table. And in that table, what columns do I want in my application? So I'm going to choose customer number, customer name, let's choose AR balance, and so on. So we pick the columns we want in our application. Done with that. Move on from there. How do I want to sort our application? I'm going to choose customer name, save and review. Right, so there's our sort by customer name. Move on from there. And it shows a preview of the application, that main body area. There are various options on the left and some drop downs at the top to go and change things about it. I'm going to choose one of these, Smart Links, to do a drill down. So I'm going to choose a drill down. And it's now showing me a list of programs that I wrote early today, maybe last week, that I can drill down to. So I'm going to choose the customer orders. So that's number 40 chosen. Back to our preview screen. So we'll see there in that main body area, there's our application with the drill down. So that's a simple application defined for the moment. So all we've done is given it a name, picked some columns, sorted it, defined a drill down, and we'll click done. Let's get on with it. So it's now going to generate our Java servlet for us. So it's getting on with that creation process. It's writing a Java servlet. It's also creating a HTML presentation layer for us for the PC, and a presentation layer for a tablet, and a presentation layer for a smartphone. So one program and three presentation layers. And it's now cooked, it's built, it's now ready for us to run. So if we run it, here is our application running in the PC. So there it is, list of customers. If I choose to drill down on one of these customers, it'll pass the customer number through, and we've got the customer orders, go back up, and so on. I've got a selection panel here where I can do some filtering by any different criteria. That's all part of our application. Okay, what I'll now do is let's run the same application. So I'm just going to copy my URL, put that into this other browser. Okay, just I'll move my browsers sort of side by side. What I'm trying to do is show you here, my browser on the left is I've got Chrome up on my PC pretending to be a smartphone. On the right, I've got Firefox basically pretending to be a PC for demonstration purposes today. And so the one on the left is deliberately smaller to behave like a smartphone, to be able to show you that. So if I, this is the one that we've created, we've seen it on the right. On the left, you haven't seen that one in operation properly yet. But if I click to see different customers, you'll see how it's doing smartphone type interaction of concertinaing, expanding and contracting the screen. If I drill down to the orders, we might see orders belonging to a customer. They might drill down to see a particular product. So it's interacting with our database in real time. Let's get on with the application on the right. I might change that one to be a tablet. So here's the tablet presentation there. Or switches back to, I'm going to switch it back to being a PC. Right, okay, so there we go. So we have these three presentation layers, PC on the left, smartphone on the right, tablet. And I'll just show you one other example just to finish off. show the, how the interface might look differently on a PC to how it might look on a smartphone. So this application, just go into it, I'll show you. It starts off where you choose an area, then it shows a list of stores, and then a set of pins of where they're located on the right. If we run the very same one over on our smartphone, which is the same area, it's got the same information. Because we've got the same amount of room on the smartphone, in this case, if we scroll down, we then get to the map at the bottom. And we've got large buttons for the hyperlinks, because on a smartphone, we've got our large fingers. We've got to be able to click on the right area. So you have a large button for the drill down rather than just a hyperlink as on the PC. So if I drill down for one of our stores on our smartphone, we'll then get all the information down the screen. Over to the right on the PC, if we can click to drill down and we get the info, in this case, it's with a series of tabs. So it's just that different experience that's pertinent to the target device. So that's the idea of doing a instant mobile solutions, is having this template ability with different presentation layers that work for whichever device you're creating for. And the agile solution, I've shown you how we created our application this morning. Okay, back to the main screen. So that's the creation process. That's the end of this overview today, show you how one can be agile creating solutions for multiple devices. So on the screen now are our contact details. If you're in the US, there's a phone number, UK phone number and email addresses. Please get in touch on that. Now, I've just had a few questions come in during this session. And one of them here from Pete says, can it do full-on data entry? Well, short answer is yes. We've got customers that have created full shopping cart applications or project reporting, engineer visit reports, a whole range of things, CRM applications. Full data entry, real time to the central system. So, and that's an important aspect, it's real time to that central system. AJ has asked, you change the look and feel? The way our tool works, there's a standard header, footer, style sheet that you set up, and put your corporate look and feel into that. Might take anything between 1 hour and, say, a day in total, but that's a one-off task. Then you might write, say, 40 or 50 applications that all pick up your corporate branding instantly. So, click and feel, no problem. And Mike has asked, can you restrict users to sections of the database? We achieve that with a security table. It's fairly, very easy to set up. And so you might have it that when a customer logs on, and this is how you would do it, actually, that when a customer logs on, they see only their orders, the history of their invoices. A different customer logs on, they see theirs. Or maybe a sales manager sees that logs on, he sees his customers. Or engineer logs on, he sees the visits he's got to do. So the use of that security is multi-purpose. No matter where in your business where you need a bit of security, you can achieve that. Okay. And finally, someone called S has asked, can they try it on their own database? We can certainly help sorting out a trial for anybody to show how Empower might work to achieve particular requirements for your business using your data. So please get in touch with any of those methods on the screen there if you want to see that. No other questions coming in for the moment. So if there are any after this session, please use either of those routes to get in touch. But thank you very much, everyone, for attending today. Goodbye.